This is a WBAL-TV 11 editorial with President and General Manager Dan Jarrus.
Like his story, Leo Bretholz was unforgettable. The Pikesville man took the darkest years of the Holocaust and made them remarkably a message of hope. Last week, after 93 years, Bretholz's time on Earth came to an end, but not his ability to inspire. He recounted his story to anchor Deborah Wiener and photographer Chuck Cochran when they traveled with Leo and his wife back to Europe. He was a critical part of our 2005 documentary, Survivors Among Us. This 1942 photo with the young Leo on the far left was taken in Drancy, France, before he was crammed into a cattle car bound for Auschwitz. Leo was one of the few documented jumpers who left from that train and survived. On the run in France, Bretholz became critically ill, and a young nun nursed him back to health. We brought the two together for what would be their last reunion. Leo told us that story with his characteristic charm, intellect, and ironically, humor. That is why those who knew Leo best believed he created light in the midst of that terrible darkness. Leo Bretholz referred to himself as a footnote. Nothing could be further from the truth. His story was important, his life a reason to rejoice, his example one for all of us to emulate.